Hello students, so here today we'll continue the same unit number 3, that is reconstitution of partnership firm, admission of a partner. In our previous videos we have done, that is how to calculate sacrificing ratio, how to calculate new profit sharing ratio, and also we have done the valuation of goodwill of a firm, right? And then also we have done the treatment of goodwill on admission of a partner under different situations. So today here one more new topic, that is treatment of reserve and accumulated, that is undistributed profit or losses. You see here, that is balance sheet, two sides, one is liability, another side is assets. Here you see liability side reserve, general reserve or reserve fund, and then profit and loss account, that is the profit. Asset side profit and loss account, that is the loss. Asset side profit and loss account appeared, so this is called what? Debit balance, and this is called credit balance. Okay, now this, if you find in the question this general reserve fund or profit and loss account or this side profit and loss account, then how you will treat, okay, before the admission of a new partner. So very simple, this one, at the time of admission of a partner, if there is any reserve or reserve fund or undistributed profits, that is balance in profit and loss account credit side appearing on credit, that is appearing on the liability side of the balance sheet, or losses, that is balance in profit and loss account debit appearing on the asset side of the balance sheet, this indicates profits or losses not yet transferred to capital account of the partners. Okay, that means what? Before admission of a new partner, this reserve fund or undistributed profits that is appeared on the liability side of the balance sheet, the old partners has to be distributed to their capital account. Okay, and if there is any losses, that will be bear by the old partners, not by the new partners, because before admission of a new partner, these all are appeared in the balance sheet. Okay, so how you will calculate this one? Okay, so that I'll show you how you will pass these journal entries in the books of the firm. So try to understand. If you find in the question reserve, general reserve for reserve fund given or profit and loss account given, how you will pass these journal entries? The first, these liabilities when you will transfer to their capital account, so these liabilities will be decreased, and if liability decrease, then you know that that will be debit according to American approach, right? Similarly, this profit and loss account, that is the asset side appeared, if this one distributed to the old partner before the admission of a partner, then these assets will also be decreased, and if asset decrease, that will be credit. That means this one will be credit, okay? And liability if decrease, that will be debit. Okay, and when liability will decrease and this one will be transferred to the old partners, to their old capital account, in this case their capital will increase, and if capital increase, that will be credit. Similarly, these assets when will transfer to their to the old partners capital account, in this case assets will be decreased, the assets will be credit, and other side the partners capital will be decreased. The capital if decrease, that will be debit. Very simple, very easy. Okay, so now you see here the journal entry. See, for transfer of reserve and accumulated profits, accumulated means undistributed profits. Okay, so profit and loss account will be debit, reserve fund or general reserve or reserve, that also will be debit, because these two are the liability, and when this liability transfer to their old partner's capital account, in this case liability will be decreased, and if liability decrease, that will be debit, and other side old partner's capital will be increased, and if capital increase, that will be credit, so to old partner's capital account. Narration here being the reserve and profits transferred to old partner's capital account in their old profit sharing ratio. Very simple. Then for transfer of accumulated losses, accumulated means undistributed. Okay, undistributed losses. So here what will happen, these losses which appeared on the asset side, so assets will be decreased when it will be distributed to the old partners, to their old capital, to their capital account. Okay, in this case, these assets will be decreased, and if assets decrease, that will be credit. And other side, old partners capital will be decreased, and if capital decrease, that will be debit. So that's why old partners capital account debit and to profit and loss account credit. The narration here being the loss transferred to old partners capital account in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay, so related to this, I will show you one question. Try to understand. Okay. And one more thing, after the above transfer entries, there will be no balance in these accounts, reserve and profit and loss account. Hence, such reserve profit or losses will not be shown in the new balance sheet. That means after admission of a new partner, while you prepare balance sheet, in this case, this reserve profit and loss, okay, will not be shown in the new balance sheet. Okay. Now you see the question here. Amar Deka and Benu Borua are partners in a firm sharing profit in the ratio of 3:2. So these two are the old partners and their old ratio is 3:2. At the time of admission of Kumar, okay, at the time of admission of a Kumar, Kumar is a new partner, balance in reserve fund stood how much rupees? 10,000 rupees. The reserve fund, that is the liability, okay, that is how much rupees? 10,000 rupees. And profit and loss account, that is the debit balance, rupees 6,000, that is the asset side appeared, okay, that is the loss. 6,000 rupees. Past necessary journal entries for the above transaction. So what you will do, the reserve fund, when you will distribute to the old partners, okay, in this case, what will happen, this liability will be decreased. If liability decrease, what will happen? If liability decrease, that will be debit. That means this reserve fund will be debit. Just now I have shown, okay, reserve fund will be debit. And other side, the old partners capital will increase. That means capital will be credit. Similarly, profit and loss account debit, there is rupees 6,000, which is appeared in the asset side of the balance sheet. So when you will distribute this profit and loss account to the old partners, to their old to their capital account, in this case, these assets also will be decreased. And if assets decrease, that will be credit. That means profit and loss account will be credit. And other side, old partners capital will also will be decreased. And when capital will be decreased, that will be debit. That means profit and loss account will be credit and old partners capital account will be debit. That already I have shown now here, journal entry, right? So you see the solution here. Now you see this journal entry here in the books of the firm, journal, date, particulars, ledger, folio, debit and credit. Okay, first of all, reserve fund given in the question, right? Reserve fund is the liability, and when this reserve fund distributed to the old partners capital account, in this case liability will be decreased, and if liability decreases, that will be debit. That's why reserve fund account debit. How much reserve fund? It was 10,000 rupees. Now this 10,000 rupees will be distributed to the old partners in their old ratio. So to Amar Deka's capital account, and then to Benus Borua's capital account. These two are old partner, right? And their capital will be increased. So that's why this one credited. Now 10,000 distributed in their old ratio. What is the old ratio? 3:2, right? So 3:2. That means 3/5 × 10,000. The 5 to 10, 36, 6,000. So how much left? 4,000. That will be for Benus Borua capital account. Okay. The narration being the balance of reserve fund credited to what? Old partners capital account in their old ratio. That is 3:2 before Kumar's admission. Okay. Next point is that profit and loss account given also in the question. That is the debit balance. So that is the loss, that means is appeared on the asset side. So when we'll distribute this one asset, that is the profit and loss account, it will be decreased. And if asset decrease, that will be what? That will be credit. So that's why profit and loss account credited. How much it was? 6,000 rupees. Now this 6,000 rupees will be distributed between these two old partners in their old ratio. Old ratio was 3:2, right? So now you see when these losses will be distributed to the old partners. In this case, old partners capital will be decreased. So if capital decrease, that also will be what? Debit. Okay. That's why Amar Deka's capital account debit and Benu Borua's capital account debit. Now this 6,000, if you calculate in the old ratio, that is 3:2. So 6,000 into 3/5, 5, what is that? 3/5 × 6,000. So 5 to 12 is 60. That means 3,600. Okay, and remaining 2,400. That is Benu Vorwa's capital account debit. Okay, so now you see the narration. Being the debit balance of profit and loss account transferred to old partner's capital account in their old ratio before Kumar's admission. Okay, so in this way you have to pass the journal entry when will appear this reserve, general reserve or reserve fund or profit and loss, either debit balance or credit balance, how you will pass the journal entries before the admission of the new partner. Okay, got it? Okay, student, one more new topic, very important topic, but today just I'll show you this point. In my next video I'll give the explanation. Okay, there is a new topic, is a revaluation of assets and reassessment of liabilities. On the admission of a partner, the new partner may not agree with the value of assets and liabilities as shown in the balance sheet, because with the passage of time the value of some assets fall while the value of some others rise. Right, jab ek partner ka admission hota hai, theek hai na, to jo new partner hota hai wo agree nahi hota hai with the value of assets and liabilities as shown in the balance sheet. Theek hai, new partner admission hone se pehle jo balance sheet hai, उस बैलेंस शीट में एसेट्स और लाइबिलिटीज तो होगा ही होगा, है ना? नहीं तो उस बैलेंस शीट में जो एसेट्स और लाइबिलिटीज का जो वैल्यू है वो न्यू पार्टनर एग्री नहीं होता है. क्यों? क्योंकि बिकॉज विद द पैसेज ऑफ टाइम का वजह से कुछ एसेट्स का वैल्यू क्या हो जाता है, डिक्रीज हो जाता है, और कुछ एसेट्स का वैल्यू क्या हो जाता है, इंक्रीज हो जाता है. ठीक है, इन द केस ऑफ लाइबिलिटीज इट इज पॉसिबल दैट द अमाउंट पेएबल मे बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दो स्टेटेड in the balance sheet. It may be that some assets or liabilities have not been recorded in the books, therefore the value of assets and the amount of liabilities should be brought to their correct value so that the incoming partner do not suffer. This is done by making necessary adjustment in the value of assets and liabilities. तो balance sheet में जो assets और liabilities दिखाई देता है new partner admission होने से पहले, उसका कुछ adjustment करना पड़ता है. ठीक है, तो this adjustment are carried out through, तो ये जो adjustment होता है assets और liabilities का, ये through a revaluation account. तो इसको क्या कहा जाता है? Revaluation account. ये जो assets और liabilities है इसका revaluation होता है. ठीक है, तो revaluation of assets and liability. ठीक है, the profit or loss arising from revaluation is adjusted in the existing partner's capital account in their old profit sharing ratio. If the capital of the partners are fixed, the profit or loss arising from revaluation is adjusted in the existing partner's current account. ठीक है, अगर fixed capital method है तो current account, और अगर fluctuating है तो capital account. Okay, तो जो यहां में जो revaluation account लिखा है, revaluation account is also known as, you remember student, profit and loss adjustment accounts. Sometimes come in final exam. Revaluation account is also known as what? तो profit and loss adjustment account. ठीक है, तो ये मैंने कुछ बात बता दिया यहां में कि जब assets और liabilities का revaluation किस तरह होता है. ठीक है, liabilities का reassessment कैसा होता है, assets का revaluation कैसा होता है. ये जब एक नया partner admission होता है, तो admission होने से पहले एक balance sheet होता है old partners का, right? तो उस बैलेंस शीट में एसेट्स और लाइबिलिटीज अपियर्ड होता है. ठीक है ना, तो वो एसेट्स और लाइबिलिटीज किसका होगा? ओल्ड पार्टनर्स का होगा, न्यू पार्टनर एडमिशन आने से पहले. तो उस पर हक किसका है, राइट किसका है? सिर्फ ओल्ड पार्टनर्स का ही है ना? नहीं, लेकिन एक बात है कि जब एसेट्स, ये जो एसेट्स और लाइबिलिटीज अपियर्ड हो रहा है बिफोर एडमिशन ऑफ ए न्यू पार्टनर, तो इससे क्या होगा, जैसे जैसे टाइम जाएगा कुछ एसेट्स का वैल्यू क्या होगा, डिक्रीज होगा, कुछ एसेट्स का वैल्यू इंक्रीज होगा. लाइबिलिटी इसी तरह, लाइबिलिटी भी जो है कुछ इंक्रीज होता है, कुछ डिक्रीज होता है. ठीक है, तो इसका एडजस्टमेंट करना पड़ता है. ओके, तो ये जो डिस्कशन है इसका एक्सप्लेनेशन मैं नेक्स्ट वीडियो में देने वाला हूं. ठीक है, आज मैंने ऐसा दिखा दिया कि रिवेल्यूशन ऑफ एसेट्स और रीअसेसमेंट ऑफ लाइबिलिटीज का मतलब क्या है. ठीक है, तो इन माय नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई विल शो यू दिस रिवेल्यूशन एसेट्स एंड रीअसेसमेंट ऑफ लाइबिलिटीज. ओके, तो ओके देन, थैंक यू फॉर टुडे.